Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. Recently I got a question from MasterWasp74 about what's my take on Corona versus FStorm, and how does FStorm, as being a GPU rendering engine, handle GPU memory? Keep in mind that I won't be covering all features of both rendering engines, as that would create a 5-hour long video, so I'll just stick with my quick observations of both. So let's start with Corona versus FStorm. Here I have an example of side-by-side comparison of two renders. One is made with FStorm and one is made with Corona. Now, visually, they look almost identical, but there are some differences, and not only visual differences, but differences in workflow. Let's start with lighting. I noticed that when working with Corona that I feel much more satisfied with how everything looks once you place your first light. I just love the contrast that those lights create. For example, if you see these shadows happening on the wall, I kind of feel like I had to invest much more time in FStorm to achieve these. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not like I spent another half an hour setting up the lights. This is a thing of minutes, but what counts is how quickly you're satisfied when you started working. Another thing is, when the lights are hitting plants in Corona, I am more satisfied with how these look. So for example, you have these nice overly lit parts which look really really dreamy, and I don't remember achieving those quickly with FStorm. Now let's go to another topic, and that is materials. I know when I was creating this image that I spent much less time tweaking the materials on the FStorm. Not only that, but I noticed that tweaking materials in Corona is extremely laggy. So I had scenarios that when I would do a certain change, that I would have to wait like 20 seconds for example, just changing the tiling for something to happen. Generally, the more complex the material it is, the slower it's gonna get. I don't know if there is some sort of cache somewhere that's filling and things go slow, but for example, I have this velvet chair, and this is the material that I got. You see, it's not a simple material, it has a lot of nodes, but if I go and change, for example, the styling, so I'm gonna click now, I'm still waiting for the result. Still waiting. And now it resumes. So once you set up your scene, when you put all the models in, you have a large portion of tweaking with the materials, and generally you're losing tons of time just waiting for Corona to update, where with FStorm things are happening much more faster. So if I take a tiling here and change it, let's say from 5 to 2, the result happens within a second. So if I switch back to 5, it happens. If I move these, it happens. With Corona, it's just wait, and that's the thing that I don't really like about material workflow in Corona. Now let's take a look about some key visual differences. So do you see this smudge here and this one here? Now these are shading issues. This model was downloaded online, it's just a CAD model, where with FStorm I didn't have any problems when I was rendering that. I know that's a super easy thing to fix, but in Corona you still have to deal with it. Now the other thing is, if you take a look at these white tiles, they are actually glass tiles. They are completely see-through glass tiles. And when you look at it in the FStorm, you can really notice that they're made of glass. You have this backlight. It seems like it's caustics, even though FStorm does not support caustics unlike Corona, but I haven't managed to get that same effect with Corona, and here they just feel like white tiles. I even tried turning on caustics, maybe I will get that effect, but I didn't have much luck. Now let's talk about the main topic here, and that's rendering speed. GPU versus CPU. For my GPU, I'm using NVIDIA RTX 3090, and for my CPU, I'm using a Threadripper 3970X CPU with 32 cores. First to say, FStorm doesn't have a denoiser. Corona does have a denoiser, but I don't use Corona's denoiser because I think denoisers kill all these nice little details that you work so hard on, and it just makes them flat. So if I do need to denoise something, I'm most likely going to use Neat Image. But when it comes to render times, FStorm image was rendered in roughly 16 minutes, where Corona image without the denoiser was rendered in 1 hour and 20 minutes. Now that's a massive difference. Now if you're a fan of denoisers, you could drop those numbers down to like 20-25 minutes even, but at what cost? All those hard working noise bumps that you put on the walls and everything, all will be just flat. And I believe the image is gonna, you know, give kind of artificial vibe because of it. One of the things that I really like about Corona is that it's integrated into Max nicely. So you can use all these sweet maps and all of them are compatible. You can put procedural maps into displacements, etc. and everything will work fine, where with FStorm, you're kind of limited to just these few. Don't get me wrong, these can do a lot of work, so in most cases you don't need anything extra, but from time to time you do remember that native Max features can do something that you would really like to have, and FStorm does not support it, so yeah, you kind of learn to live with it. Next part of the comment was, I see you use FStorm. I imagine there is a large VRAM hit when using displacement maps with a GPU renderer. I have been using Corona for so long, I can't really remember the differences between GPU and CPU renders. Others than I know, back in the day anyway, you had to try to manage VRAM usage to properly take advantage of the GPU rendering speed. Well, since back in the day and now, a lot of things have changed. FStorm handles displacements with ease. I don't remember having any problems with too much displacement or something like that. And I'm talking from the perspective of having a 2080 Ti card with 11 GB of RAM, and not from the perspective of 3090 that I have now, that has 24 GB of RAM. Now, speaking of changes, latest info that I know is that FStorm can take 384 million unique polygons onto a GPU, and it will take only 16.13 gigabytes of GPU memory. With 384 million polygons, you can do a goddamn big scene. I don't remember hitting the cap of my memory, even back when I had the 2080 Ti with 11 gigabytes of RAM. I think I hit the cap maybe once. But if you do, there is this really cool feature in FStorm, it's called bitmap compression. So what it basically does, it will compress all your textures 4 times without losing visual quality of the texture, but you will gain about 5 to 10% speed drop, which is super fine. On the other hand, when it comes to memory, for example, the displacement that I have here, if I turn it off, you can see that my scene currently uses 0.79 gigabytes of memory. If I turn off my displacement, you will see that I will only lose 200 megabytes. If we want to talk about an actual example, so this is the room I did a year ago, and you can see this whole scene used 2.79 gigabytes. And it's filled with props, filled with displays. A wall has a displacement, a rug has a displacement, towels have a displacement. And I think this whole scene has around 100 textures. And like I said, 2.79 gigabytes when it comes to render time. I know it's not denoised fully, but this has been rendering for only 5 minutes, and this is the result. And now to conclude the big question, which one is better, Corona or FStorm? I would say that they are roughly the same. There are a few things where FStorm is heavily kicking Corona's ass, and there are things where Corona is kicking FStorm's ass. Corona has light mix to tweak lights after rendering is done. FStorm has a parallax bump which simulates a real life displacement but impacts the system and rendering speed as just ordinary bump. Corona has caustics, FStorm has geopattern, etc. But the main difference is FStorm's speed because of GPU. At the end of the day, whichever engine you choose to work with, you can't miss, as they both are state-of-the-art rendering engines. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's comparison. As always, keep those render times low and see you in the next video. Bye!